what part did music play in your understanding of the civil rights movement and the struggle of equality?
I was born at a time where the Black Power movement was still in full effect. So people like Huey P. Newton, H. Rap Brown, Eldridge Cleaver, Bobby Seals, all these people were still fighting for equality, not just for Black people, but all people. So as a small child, I was aware of all of that, right? But of course, Dr. King and Malcolm and Medgar Evers and people like that had been assassinated. The music part, it's interesting. You had some people out there who really paid attention to what was going on in society, going on in the United States. People like James Brown, Marvin Gaye, Sly and the Family Stone. And these are people that, as a child, my father really loves music, always loved music. Back then, there were no CDs or cassette tapes, you know.
Yeah, it was vinyl.
So it was vinyl, man. You know, albums, 45s. Really, for me, you know, being able to go through my father's albums and you know, he would play them when he wasn't at work. So, you know, I grew up hearing those songs and hearing what they were talking about in terms of justice and equality. And I think it really made me think about, you know, the world and maybe what should be done or could be done to try to help the world and especially this country.
Father, Father, we don't need to escalate. War's not the answer, for only love can conquer. You know we got to find a way to bring some loving. Oh, yeah. Picket lights, picket signs, punish me with brutality. Talk to me.